Clinton Bay Elementary School wish to thank Magruder Hospital in Port Clinton for their generous local support of our edition of News 6 and the other friends of this broadcast who provided additional funding.
Welcome to this week's edition of News 6. Today's program is brought to you by the 5th and 6th grade classes of Put-in Bay School. Put-in Bay is located on South Bass Island in Ottawa County, founded in 1858. Our community has year-round populations of 500 people.
Lake Erie is the site of an important naval victory for the United States. In 1813, Americans led by Oliver Perry defeated the British. Reporter Jason Riddell shows us how we honor his memory today.
Hi, I'm Jason Riddell, and we're making a stop at South Bass Island's biggest attraction. I'm talking about the monument that is dedicated to Commodore Oliver Hazard Perry.
Commodore Oliver Hazard Perry was a young American naval hero who fought during the War of 1812. He was one of five brothers who served in the U.S. Navy, and he was from Newport, Rhode Island. In fact, when Oliver Hazard Perry joined the U.S. Navy, he was only 13 years old. Perry served through the quasi-war with France in the late 1790s, and he fought during the Barbary Wars in the early 1800s. And by 1813, Oliver Hazard Perry was a 27-year-old man who had already had 14 years in the U.S. Navy.
Even before you get to the island, you can't help noticing this large memorial.
The monument is 352 feet above Lake Erie. The observation deck where people go up to view the lake is 317 feet above the lake. At the base, it's 45 feet in diameter. The walls are 9 1/4 feet thick at the base and taper to 5 3/4 at the top.
Perry's monument is one of the most popular tourist sites in the area.
Visitation to the memorial is increasing just about every year. When the monument first opened in 1915, 25,000 visitors went up in the monument. In 1998, approximately 200,000 people visited this memorial.
This is Jason Riddell reporting for News 6.
Is a good place to observe wildlife in the Great Lakes. Students from Ohio State University have been coming here to study for many years. Reporter Samantha Cadres tells us more.
Hi, I'm Samantha Dress, and we're here to see a living laboratory.
The Stone Laboratory is the oldest freshwater field research station in the country.
Stone Laboratory is operated by the Ohio State University, and its big purpose is as a multifunctional research facility based on freshwater and aquatic sciences. We have Gibraltar Island, which is in Put-in Bay, a 4-acre island with a classroom, dormitories, research facilities, the research vessel, the biolab, as well as facilities including a lab, an administrative office on South Bass Island.
Research done here can help other freshwater areas like Lake Erie.
A lot of the research that we do here consists of plants, fish, invertebrates, and we have people from all over the country doing research here, sharing information. So basically, this is a hub for aquatic research. Well, as you may know, zebra mussels are an exotic species. They showed up in Lake Erie roughly 10 years ago. And they've caused a lot of change in the lake, some good, some bad.
Students of all
ages can learn something new here every day.
Well, most of the college students are here during the summer, and at any one time there could be over 100 students. During the spring and the fall, we have over 4,000 grade school students, high school, and some college come through for aquatic workshops, one-day activities.
This is Samantha Dress reporting for News 6.
Today's Kids Week question is, what kind of work did you do over the summer?
I mow the lawn and check the beds at my family's bed and breakfast.
I sell lemonade to tourists riding bikes and golf carts.
I take off tires for my dad's car business.
I babysat for a guide at Perry's Cave.
I mow the lawn at my dad's carryout.
I ring up merchandise at a gift shop downtown.
Welcome to Putnam-based school. We have one teacher for both 5th and 6th grade classes, which in the same room.
Our classroom has 16 students.
Our computer room is one place we use technology.
We also come here for typing classes.
This is our gymnasium.
We have gym, school music concerts, and other assemblies here.
We play basketball here after school.
Our playground is blue and white, which are the school colors.
The person who watches us is a nurse.
Our library is built inside of our school.
We learn and discover new things here.
Before modern technologies, boaters relied on a bright light to avoid dangerous areas. Those lights were usually located in a house with a tall tower. Reporter Daniel Neese takes us on a visit to the old lighthouse of South Bass Island.
Hi, I'm Daniel Neese, and it's time for us to see the light.
Actually, South Bass Island Lighthouse doesn't light up anymore, but it did for many years.
This lighthouse was in operation from 1897 to 1962. The island needed a lighthouse because shipwrecks would occur among the many islands of Lake Erie in the Western Basin.
Unlike other lighthouses that are really large towers, this lighthouse is really a house.
Our lighthouse on Putnam Bay is a Queen Anne Victorian house made of brick with an adjacent tower that is attached, which the lighthouse keeper used to tend the lantern.
The island's lighthouse served an important role for many years. Now, it's no longer needed.
The way old lighthouses like this actually worked was a very small light source was magnified by a prism. The prism focused the light beam into one strong light. In 1962, technology allowed for no need for a lighthouse keeper. A tall metal tower was built, which contained the automatic light. Today, the lighthouse is used to house visiting scientists who come to South Bass Island for research.
This is Daniel Neese reporting for News 6.
That's all for this edition of News 6. Thanks for watching. Be sure to tune in next week for more news from around the Northwest Ohio. Goodbye.